I just went to a wedding over the summer. It's in Newport, Rhode Island, gorgeous venue, right on the water, a lot of yachts, right in the background of all the pictures. I don't really get the concept of yachts, but it's like, hey babe, you know how we have this beautiful, gorgeous $1 million house? You know what would make it better? If it could sink.
My name is Sarah Hollowed, and I'm a painter. I've been painting since I was tiny because I couldn't speak. And my parents were always expecting it to come really fast. Eventually, I'd say my first, you know, real word, but I didn't until I was like 4 or 5.
This is Sarah. She's a prolific artist and a self-professed weirdo.
So I decided I just wanted to keep drawing. Everything I wanted, I would draw. And my parents really accepted it. And I think there's something so strange about artists, because every kid likes to draw. Everybody colors, but the ones who stay with it are so weird, and I can't figure out why. Why I was the one who stayed with it. Why there's so many of my friends who just stayed with it when kids just love to color.
When you say artists are weird, would you call yourself weird?
Yeah.
There are times that she actually cannot function without art.
I think anybody who just has this idea that they just want to create, it's kind of like the way a lot of drug addicts work, where it's the middle of the night and you realize you can't sleep unless you just do this. It's like this, I call it an art attack. It's just like, I feel like I can't function without it. So I do think it's kind of weird.
When she's lost and alone, art is there to calm her down.
Art helps me through so many tough times, because there's certain things that art's always been my friend. When I don't have any other friends, I know that there's always going to be a canvas there that I can just speak to, and it won't call me weird or call me annoying or anything because it can't speak. So that's how I get out all my emotions.
She's currently working on a mural she was commissioned to paint by the Human Rights Coalition here at Weymouth High.
I'd say that without art, I wouldn't be much of anything. I'd just be like a person who didn't know how to get things out. And I've turned to other ways in the past when I didn't have art. Just really bad things. Things that you shouldn't be doing to your body, things you shouldn't be doing to your soul, but it was a way to help myself. But art has truly been the thing that's kept me together. And I think it's helped me through hard times and not going to past things that I used to do and substances and certain things. It's its own substance of sorts.
Mm-hmm.
But you have a final product when you're finished with it.
Well, there is this sexy frog, or this descending hen. You know, if it Sarah's on it, it'll be good. She also played a role in publishing a children's book, written by J.J. Minier. Naya Papaya, The Puzzle, features illustrations done entirely by Sarah. This is her favorite piece.
I was in Savers, and I stumbled across this horrifically ugly picture of a ship. It was so gross, and I decided, but it was such a beautiful canvas, and I had this gorgeous frame, so I decided to buy it, and then I decided, what could I fit on this? A giraffe! So I did this really bizarre giraffe right over the painting, and knowing that ugly painting is still underneath is really exciting to me.
Hi. My name's Paula, and I am 18 years old, and I love doing art.
Now meet Paula. Paula immigrated from Mexico in 2014, but keeps her culture alive here in the States in more ways than one. Paula is working together with Sarah on the mural.
Started painting a year ago. Absolutely have no idea what I'm doing most of the time, but I really, really enjoy it.
For her, art is a way of dealing with the hostility and ill will she felt when she got here.
The only way where I can express the pain and like sadness that I had throughout moving from Mexico to the United States and feeling unwelcome. And I find that as a way to escape from that and take all that pain into like something beautiful, like an art piece.
It's also a way of honoring the life she left behind in Mexico.
I do. My Mexican roots, it has a Mexican culture. Like, you can see and you can tell that that's like a Mexican painting. And I did that on purpose just so I can always be surrounded by my roots and remember to never let them go, because it's also part of me. My mom was like, hey, I got this paint for sale at Michael's. And I was like, that is crazy. And I started doing like little things. I started like doing little mountains and like stuff. And then it just kept going until I had my first heartbreak. And that really changed everything, because I was like, I had so much pain and anger and all with it, that I made my first painting, which is like the yellow skeleton who's burning on fire. And ever since that, I was like, wow, I can express so, so much.
This is her favorite piece.
I think Las Dos Paulas, which is the two Paulas. That painting is pretty much the whole sum of my whole portfolio, which is my how I deal with my two identities and like how I deal with my Mexican side with this, with the new person that I am here in the United States. And the left is just me, my normal clothes that you get, like you would see me in school wearing, sure, with all of my jewelry that I wear. And I put it behind, I put New York City, because it is the closest thing in this country that I have to Mexico. And then in the right side, it's me being proud of who I am, which took me a long while to accept who I was because of all the hate and unwelcomeness that I see in the world and in my school, mm-hmm, for being Mexican. I fear that someday I'm gonna forget my roots, which is why I always paint about it, I always read about it, I always hear the music about it. And that is the right side, it's me enjoying my culture and being me, my full Mexican self.
Alright, so I held the door open for a lady the other day, and she said, thank you, sir. I didn't have the heart to tell her that I was a woman. I didn't want to like ruin her day. But I ran into her again in the bathroom, and I'm pretty sure I did like just that. There is a peeping Tom in the women's restroom. Nope, it's just a lesbian. You're alright.
Art is everywhere. Theoretically, anything can be art. Architecture can be art. Design and creation of any sort can be art. This is Cam. He's a metal fabricator. He's making a boat. Okay, not a real boat. It's more of a statue, which will be gifted to the local yacht club. He's been working on it for a number of months now, and it's just about done. Let's check back with him soon. Oh, and this backtrack you're hearing? That's MJ Coulson. Now, from what I hear, this next bit coming up is one hell of a performance. So without further delay, let's see what they can do.
It's not a one.
seems as though Cam is making great progress. Keep it up, Cam.
Cause I love you, and I hope that you're